Sean Irvine hit 93 as Hampshire dominated day two of their match against host Durham. Hampshire resumed on 319 for 6 and lost McManus to Onions early on for 5, caught by the sub fielder. Berg and Irvine combined to put on 95 for the 8th wicket at nearly 5 and over, taking the game away from the hosts, although Irvine was lucky to survive when edging Borthwick just short of slip. Berg continued to defy his position of a number 10 as Hampshire secured 4 batting points for the first time this season, the Durham attack badly missing Rushworth, who was injured yesterday. Berg eventually was to become a second victim to the part-time medium pace of Jennings. Burnham with the catch, Berg gone for 56. Hampshire were 424 for 8 at lunch, and thereafter Irvine continued to move towards his ton. Irvine was to fall 7 short of 100 though, bowled by Coughlin for 93 when trying one shot too many, prompting Hampshire to declare on 472 for 9. In reply, Stoneman and Jennings put on 37 for the first wicket, before McLaren bowled Stoneman for 17. Hampshire had a second wicket in identical fashion when Borthwick was defeated by McLaren for just 5. With Durham 57 for 2, rain intervened, but when play resumed, Jennings and Burnham took the host through to the close on 36 and 19 not out respectively. Durham 79 for 2 at stumps, still trailing Hampshire by 393 and needing another 243 runs to avoid the follow on, though the hosts still have 8 first innings wickets in hand. Player of the day was Sean Irvine, who resumed on 14 not out and went on to make a 93 that gave Hampshire the momentum in this match. Irvine used the reverse sweep to good effect against Durham spinners Pringle and Borthwick and scored fluently off the seamers too. Irvine's knock helped Hampshire build an imposing total of 472 for 9, leaving the hosts fighting to save the follow-on in this game.